You're never gonna make it, you're not good enough. There's a million other people with the same stuff. You really think you're different? Man, you must be kidding. Think you're gonna hit it, but you just don't get it. It's impossible, it's not probable, you're irresponsible. Too many obstacles.
Hey there, so in today's tutorial, we're going to learn how to create that bus effect or that shake, call it whatever. So the most use cases, I believe, for this is going to be music videos to enhance that bass, so everything goes crazy, and then when bass over, everything is just subtle and nice. So let's jump into Premiere and I will show you what you need to do in order to get the same effect. So I already imported our footage and our audio that we're going to work with, and the first thing we need to do is we need to hear our audio track and set the markers. So basically there is two ways to set a marker. One is on entire timeline and one on a track itself. So when track selected, if you press M key, it will set a marker on your track. If nothing is selected, let me remove this marker. If nothing is selected, if you press M key, you will have it on your timeline. So we're gonna hear our audio and set the markers. So you can already see that I placed my markers, but let me explain how to put them. So basically you're hearing your audio, and when you hear that bass, you have to like press M key. For example, if this is our bass, let's assume. If I hear that sound, I press M, and I know that my bass starts somewhere here, so I know where to place my effect. After you set all the markers, you need to go to the project and create new item adjustment layer. Okay, drag this somewhere above your video. Then go to the effects and search for directional blur. Drag this to our adjustment layer, and you can see that we have like direction and blur length, and we don't need the direction, we need the blur length, and set it like something like 60, and you can already see how it affects our image. What we need to do is drag this to our first marker here. Let's go and zoom in a bit. So we need to cut a couple of frames. Let's press C to cut, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's do 10 cuts. Okay. Press V and remove the rest. Okay. So select every other frame and remove it. Something like so. What we want to do next is we want to go to the first, and it's set to 60, and we want to decrease the effect by 5. So go to 55, then go to 50, then go to 45, and the last one will be 40. Okay, so it will decrease that shake. And what you want to do next is you want to select your effect, your shake, and holding Alt, move to another marker here and drop it. So let's view it.
We're gonna make it, you're not good.
Something like so. And this is kind of long buses here, but there is like one boom here and one boom here. So for that, we're gonna copy this. Sorry, we're gonna select this, hold Alt, copy. And we're gonna leave only the one bit of one hit and one more here, and let's view it.
Never gonna make it, you're not good enough, there's a million other people.
So you can see it's like one boom and one shake, so it makes more sense. So here that boom is kind of long. I don't know how to call it. Bass is long, or I don't know, the beat is long.
You're never gonna make it, you're not good enough, there's a million other people.
So, and also if you want to have black bars, you want to have it above all the effects, so the effect itself doesn't affect the black bars. So create another adjustment layer, drag it above everything, extend it like so. And what you want to do is you want to search for the crop effect, drag and drop to our adjustment layer, and we want to cut top part and the bottom part, something like so. And let's play that.
You're never gonna make it, you're not good enough. There's a million other people with the-
So you get the idea, right? I'm not going to copy this to another markers. So this is the way how to create that bus shake effect for your videos. So guys, this is it for today's tutorial, and I hope you liked it. And if yes, please put the thumbs up. It will help a ton. And I want to say thank you to all of you, and for comments like this, it's just means the world for me. And it's like pushing me to create more and to do more, to get better at things and to bring you more value, I believe. I'm bringing value here. Well, obviously this comment says like so,